the recognized worldwide leader in sports.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Wrestling Challenge. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, along with Bobby the Brain Heenan, who really has the fans up in arms here. Batten down a hatch is great action coming your way right now. Let's do it. Wrestling Challenge, all kinds of action, exciting things happening. The barber, Brutus Beefcake, will be cutting and strutting. You can bet on it. Mr. Fuji's latest find. What an unbelievable individual this guy is, Brain.
Certainly is.
Killer Khan.
Uh-oh, he's
back. Return to the World Wrestling Federation of JYD, the Junkyard Dog. He's going to be making some enemies. And, of course, as we promised, the special title defense of the Intercontinental Championship, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, putting it on one-on-one on the line against the number one challenger, the Honky Tonk Man.
And the Colonel. And the Colonel.
This next attraction is a tag team bout scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring at a total combined weight of 460 pounds, first from Fort Worth, Texas, Don Driggers. His tag team partner from Milford, Connecticut, Mario Mancini. The opponents making their way to the ring, accompanied by their manager, Mr. Fuji, and the handler, Kim Chi, at a total combined weight of 708 pounds from Samoa, Sika. From Uganda, the Ugandan headhunter, Kamala.
Wow, talk about awesome duos. It certainly looks like that Kamala hasn't missed too many deals lately.
How'd you like him knocking on your door after you've done it to go to the movies?
Please, or to the prom.
Great.
These guys are awesome. They are going to terminate the careers of a lot of guys here in the world of professional wrestling. They don't go out there just to win. They go out there to maim somebody.
Well, you see, first of all, Monsoon, you got to give them a little leeway. You know, they don't really understand the rules. Well, they don't understand the rules that well. They're foreigners. You have to kind of help them along.
Well, that's why you have guys like Mr. Fuji. That's why you have guys like Kim Chi.
Well, they're doing the best they can.
These guys do understand the rules.
They're certainly doing the best they can.
Yeah.
Trying. I mean, I know that.
The devious one, Mr. Fuji. What a fountain of misinformation he is. Bell's gone. We're underway. It looks like Seeker's going to be the one to start this.
They seem to get along rather well, don't they?
They both have cannibalistic instincts. Kind of feel sorry for Driggers and Mancini a little bit. I'd like to see at least one more member on the other side of the team there. Make this a little fairer, don't you think? Wow.
Well, they're professional wrestlers, and they get in there with their opponents no matter who they are, and I just can't be concerned with if they need help.
No, obviously, you don't care about anybody's feelings, but you're wrong. Oh, stopped him right in the sternum.
And the members of my family.
Yeah, well, not too many members. You let a few guys get in a lot of trouble and then desert it. You want to mention any names?
You can mention Patera if you want.
Yes.
You can mention them all you want. But he won't be around much longer. I've got plans.
Yeah, sure.
Big plans.
I've got plans for you. I've got news for you. Former Olympian has vowed a vendetta for you, Brain. Tag made, the big guy in, 500 pounds plus. Advertised at 470-something, but he's over that 500-pound mark. Where do you go weigh the guy? Down at the stockyards?
You get two Toledo because a foot on each one.
Whipping out the punishment. He wants him to make the tag. He wanted some fresh meat in there. Irish whips in. Look out. Oh, reverse thrust kick. He didn't learn that in the jungle, I guarantee you. He learned that from Mr. Fuji. Blatant chokehold. Come on, Rob. You can snap the guy's neck like that.
Believe me, I know.
Well, you do have a neck problem, don't you?
No, I can see that.
Actually, it was caused by your nose. You couldn't keep your nose out of other people's business. Ended up with a neck problem. Duck underneath the chop. Nice leapfrog by Driggers. Oh, got close. Oh, and drop. Goodbye, Mr. Driggers. He's not going to get up from that. Look out. Good night. He's going to need some hospital time, I'm sure.
Go, Kamala, go. My
Kamala
favorite.
Now on the outside, going way up to the top turnbuckle. Gaethje standing right in front of him. He could make peanut butter pie out of Driggers.
Look like that.
Look at Kamala holding, Sheikha holding the legs. He doesn't need to do that.
I think he's straightening his spine.
The guy is out of it.
I'd like to see that squash again.
Here it comes. Nice move on the part of Driggers. He goes over the top and then got caught in that fireman's carry. Oh, imagine the impact coming down there. He could have got a count of 100 right there, but no, he said, let me tag the big guy.
I don't like this. This I don't like. I'd rather him come off the top rope. That's my favorite.
Right now, it's special wrestler rebuttal time. Let's go to Greg DeGeorge with a K&L.
All right, with the Can-Am connection, and guys, I know you were both shocked and upset after what happened. After all, it was supposed to be a scientific match, but then Bobby Heenan and the Islanders changed all that very quickly.
That's right, Craig. You know, we're still shocked because, you know, we're actually looking forward to this match against the Islanders, but no, they had it planned all along, you know, with that Bobby Heenan. They attacked us from behind, but the Islanders, we're going to get even with you, believe me.
Tom? Just like Rick said, they jumped us from behind. What a surprise. They're a couple of great wrestlers, and you wouldn't think they'd have to resort to a man like Heenan in their corner.
This is a one-call matchup. Introducing first from San Francisco, California, weighing 263 pounds, Brutus the Barber. The opponent, from San Antonio, Texas, weighing 232 pounds, Dusty Wolf.
Well, Monsoon, I wonder how Beefcake feels being out of a job.
What do you mean out of a job? Does it look like he's out of a job?
Well, he's on his own, but he was a member of a great tradition, the Dream Team. But he was a weak link and got dumped.
He didn't get dumped.
But Johnny
left.
B told me.
Please. You guys stick together pretty good. One lies and the other one swears to it.
You're calling me a liar?
Absolutely.
Look at me, Beefcake. Look in my face and say it.
You're a liar. How's that? Brutus Beefcake going to do a lot of cutting and strutting here in the World Wrestling Federation. He's done a lot of it, and he's going to do a lot more. In fact, you could use a little trim right around the back of that horse collar.
I don't need a trim.
Let's see if Brutus can do that for you. In fact, we asked a great tag team combination, the Rougeaus, Jacques and Raymond, what they think about the hairstyling of Brutai.
You know, Raymond, ever since we've been mixed up with Brutus Beefcake, something funny has really come upon us, huh, Raymond?
Well, you know what was funny in the beginning? Brutus used to think that the crew cut was in, but now he's getting pretty stylish about it. You know, last time we saw him fixing some kind of wrestler's hair going around the head or something? You're getting pretty good, Brutus.
Brutus, keep up the good work. We'll help you anytime.
Well, two guys for Brutus to depend on should he ever need them. Obviously, the Rougeaus.
I'd sure hate to need help, and the only thing I had to look forward to is the Rougeaus.
Huh. Who you got watching your back lately?
You're going to find out eventually. I'm going to shock everybody.
You better be watching your back, too.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
Former Olympian, former strongman, Kenny Patera, has vowed to do a number on you and any member of your family that cares to get in the way.
Former convict.
No, I think this thing around your neck is stopping the circulation of blood to your brain.
There's nothing wrong with my brain.
I think there is.
Oh!
Power slam by Brutai. There it goes. He's doing a little strut right now. All remains to be seen is the cut. from behind, a sleeper. Yes, he slapped it on. Dusty Wolf in a whole lot of trouble right here. Brutus got that on there pretty good.
This guy's not fighting it properly. He's not moving my hand. The arms of Brutus Beefcake.
Do you realize the power in the upper body of Brutus Beefcake?
Oh, yeah, I know that.
Not easy to stop him once he decides to slap that sleeper on you, and he's got you in that compromising position to begin with. Referee calling for the bell. He's out to lunch. Look at Brutus. This capacity crowd wants to see the barber go to work. There's the sign for the scissors. He's got the little coat on. We saw the strutting. We saw the sleeper. Now we're, oh, what's this?
Well, a smock.
Well, at least he's going to be very neat about it. Doesn't want to get any hair all over the place. Got his little electric clippers. The stylist at work. With the
saw. Oh, that's not right, Monsoon.
The special scissors cut this week.
Well, do you have a name for every one of these?
Well, I don't know. That's what I would call this.
This poor man's unconscious. This man might have a family. This man might have to go to an important meeting tomorrow. He might have to go to a doctor, a lawyer.
Well, look at him. I think it looks good.
Oh, it's a disgrace.
Might have been an improvement.
I'll tell you, this is all going to backfire on Brutus Beefcake. Eventually, somebody is going to shave that man's head. If not, at least take those ears off him.
Brutus about to wake him up now. The crowd saying more. They want more to come off. Brutus more than willing to oblige. As Dusty Wolf doesn't have a clue.
The winner of this bout, Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Brutus victorious, and what a styling job he done.
Bring it in right now. One of the hottest teams of the World Wrestling Federation. I mean, these guys are on fire. From White Bear Lake, Minnesota, Jumpin' Jim Brunzel. From Tampa, Florida, B. Brian Blair. And gentlemen, talking about hot, we have got a very hot and volatile tag team situation here in the World Wrestling Federation, Jimmy.
Well, that's right, Gene. You know, you're talking talent and professional wrestling. You're talking the World Wrestling Federation, and that holds true for the world's tag team situation right now. Everybody wants a shot at the Hearts. There's a tremendous amount of talent. They just go right down the line, the Demos, the Hearts. You got Bravo and Valentine, and the list goes on, the Can-Am. Brian and I are in a great position right now. And hopefully, if we can remain healthy and maybe create a little mass confusion, maybe we'll get those belts soon.
All right, as we wade through that list, B. Brian Blair, let's talk about, yes, the Demolition, the British Bulldogs, the Rougeau Brothers, the new Dream Team. That list goes on and on, but ultimately, everybody wants a shot at the champions, and they just happen to be, at this time, the Hart Foundation.
That's my exact same sentiments, me and Gene. You know, I went to our main man, H.H., and I said, Hulkster, I said, we're facing some really big dudes. You know, when I saw you slam that giant down to the mat, I know you got it, what it takes. And I said, we just need a little bit of Psycon. We need something. And he said, wait a minute. Let me tell you what you need. I know exactly what you need. You need a little pump on them wings. So we went down in the dungeon in Venice Beach, right in the gym there, and we saw that steel staring us in the eyes. And we started lifting, man. We started hanging and banging. We sweat and we swore. Finally, Brunzy and I passed out. The Hulkster woke us up, and we got up and did it some more. And now we're ready, Daddy-O. We're ready, Mean Gene. As a matter of fact, we just stopped by Hazel's last week, picked us up a quart of Orange Blossom Specials, Hazel's Honey Hut, 2 quarts. We're ready to go. Our toes are tapping and our wings are flapping.
All right,
we're ready for some jaw
jumping. B. Brian Blair at Jumpin' Jim Brunzel.
This next bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first the manager, Mr. Fuji. He represents from Mongolia, weighing 310 pounds, Killer Khan. The opponent, from Columbia, South Carolina, weighing 230 pounds, Eric Cooper.
Eric Cooper in a lot of trouble this week here in the World Wrestling Federation, as Killer Khan doesn't like anybody. I don't believe he even likes Mr. Fuji.
That's probably why they get along so well.
Brutai wouldn't be able to give him much of a haircut, would he?
Looks like he did.
Look at the sumo ritual he's going through here. Wow, plants went right downstairs immediately. He doesn't have Voltors in a water brain. I got news for you. He could easily have been a member of your family. Look at the wild expression on the kisser of Killer Khan.
I predict, Monsoon, that this man here is gonna really, really do some damage to somebody someday.
Fuji's speaking to him in his native tongue, and he understands and obliges whatever Fuji would like to have done immediately. Wow, he is awesome. As we stated earlier on, Eric Cooper indeed in a lot of trouble. I would like to see Khan in there with a little stiffer competition. Maybe some of the members of your family.
Well, the money's right. That could be arranged.
Well, sure.
I wouldn't get in there with him.
Look at this. Hooks the back leg with that suplex. Really did a number on him.
Why does his hair grow like that?
Obviously, that's a special, I don't know, it may have a religious connotation. Karate kick right underneath the chin as Mr. Fuji looks on with pleasure. Caught him right in the esophagus with that shot. That'll give you a negative attitude. Gut-wrench backbreaker, yes.
The size of the feet. That's got some pretty good drivers on him.
15 or 16s. Look out. Khan going up to the top. Very high-risk move. Oh, planted that knee. Good night. Turn on the hot water. This one is history. Wow. Killer Khan and making quick work of Eric Cooper.
The winner of this bout, Killer Khan.
Killer Khan devastating.
All right, stay tuned. There's more exciting action right around the corner here as the World Wrestling Federation at its very best continues. This man, the Doctor of Style, Slick, come on in. Always very nattily attired. You must make some of that real big money. But Slick, you know, I must compliment you. You really astounded me when you brought Butch Reed to the World Wrestling Federation. But this latest acquisition of yours is absolutely awesome. One-man gang is overwhelming.
You know, Gene, you finally said something that makes a whole lot of sense when you're referring to me. And, you know, to tell you the truth about it, I'm overwhelmed, I'm ecstatic, I'm overjoyed, I'm elated about the one-man gang. Come on in, brother, let them get a real good look at it.
Guys like a house.
The big 747. You know, let me tell you something. You got to have goal and aim in life, you know what I'm saying? I've already come to the World Wrestling Federation. I've guided my men to victory after victory, but that's not enough. The ultimate in professional wrestling is to have the world's heavyweight championship. Right. And I'm convinced this is the man that's going to do it for me.
You know, I've got to say one thing, one-man gang, you're not the average dude that we'd meet on the street. As a matter of fact, you're very big. Just exactly how tall are you?
Well, Mean Gene, I stand in at 6'9", and I weigh in at 450 pounds. And this man's got what I like. He's got the green. He's got the money to pay me, to feed my body, to take me out and treat me right. And I'm going to tell you, Mean Gene, I'm on my way to the World Heavyweight Championship held by Hulk Hogan, what every man in wants, and I'm going to get it. You can bank on it.
All right, I thank you. Very impressive. One of the biggest men in all of professional sports today, the one-man gang. He is managed by the Doctor of Style, Slick. Stay tuned. We're right back.
This next bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 237 pounds, Steve Lombardi. The opponent from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 286 pounds, the Junkyard Dog.
Man is a thief. The man is a thief.
What are you talking about?
WrestleMania 3, after he had to kneel and bow, he tried to make off with the crown and the cape of the king.
He's got that 15-foot chain, that's all he really needs. Junkyard Dog on a triumphant return here to the World Wrestling Federation. Talked to him earlier on and he said he's in great shape, ready for any kind of action, and ready to do some unusual things. Lombardi may be the first recipient of some of those unusual things. Lombardi, of course, has come a long way since his inception here in the World Wrestling Federation. Earlier on, we had a chance to question Mr. Slick and Mr. Volkov as to what some of their thoughts on the dog. Let's hear.
What do I think about the dog? Well, I tell you, Holmes, you might be back, but when you cross the bad man's path, you're gonna be way back, back across the tracks, Holmes.
This really swing I am.
Holmes? Who's Holmes?
I think he's talking about old Thumper there.
Wait.
I like it. Let's refer to him as Holmes from now on.
What did Nikolai have to say? What was that? Was that Russian he was speaking?
Surely it was.
Are you paying attention at all, Brandon?
Yes, I'm paying attention.
You have a clue as to what's going on here?
I just had to take some medication. This neck's bothering me again.
Okay. Junkyard Dog with a reversal on Lombardi. Big backdrop. Whoa! Long way down for Steve.
Happened to be on top of everything.
Yeah. You need some additional help, maybe some psychiatric help.
It's my neck, not my brain.
Yeah. Well, that horse collar you're wearing is obviously cutting the circulation to the brain. Lombardi hard into the turnbuckle. And the dog just relentlessly stalking him down. Atomic drop coming up, yes. And Lombardi right through, almost hit the steel post. That's put a lot of guys out of action for a while. Of course, Lombardi didn't quite reach it, lucked out.
Uh-oh.
Only temporarily, though. Look out, power slam city, yes. He nailed him with it. That's all for Lombardi. What? Grab the cakes and do some juking.
Oh, no, he's not going to dance, is he?
I hope so. Junkyard Dog looking around for some jukers. There we got one. Oh, the dog finally saw. Yes, there it goes. You even got a Junkyard Dog t-shirt on. I love it.
The winner of this bout, the Junkyard Dog.
Junkyard Dog very victorious in a big way here on his return. And look at this power slam. Nobody's going to get up from that.
Oh, yeah.
One easy 1-2-3 count. Dave Hebner giving him the do. Right now, let's go to another of our colleagues, Greg DeGeorge, along with the outlaw, Ron Bass.
They call Ron Bass the outlaw for good reason, because as you know, the outlaw has been known to bend and break rules over time. And What is the business?
When you talk about somebody bending and breaking rules, that means they do something behind somebody's back. And I never do anything behind anybody's back. I'll look you eyeball to eyeball and look you toe to toe, baby. Let me tell you something, what I'm coming out here for now is to introduce a friend of mine. We're going to call her old Betsy, huh? And let me tell you something, people. There's a lot of people like Hulk Hogan, Tito Santana, Ricky Steamboat. There's a bunch of people out there. You're going to be feeling the pain. You're going to be feeling the sting of old Betsy before I'm done. Because when the outlaw, he first got to the... He says, hey, you're going to take notice, and I guarantee you, I've got the thing right here to make you turn around and look at the big outlaw, because the big outlaw is a man to be feared, and right here is something that's backing me up. So people, whenever the outlaw's on the card, you better believe I'm going to be there live and in color, and I'll bet you right by my side, I'll be looking for you.
Superstar is shocking everybody with his quick recovery. And let me tell you something, in no small way, his return home has helped immensely. Just being in that Arizona air, working in the 100-degree heat in the mountains, well, that return home may be his best therapy to date.
Well, Superstar, after the extent of the surgery, the things that you have gone through, a brand new metal hip, what are we doing here in desolate Arizona?
Craig, said Superstar Billy Graham. I've got to get back. I got to hear the roar of the crowd. I got to feel the pandemonium. It's in my blood. I had to come back here to my roots, to where you got to survive, Superstar Billy Graham, Superstar. Out here with the snakes, the scorpions, the heat, and the desolation.
The Superstar has been recovering quite well, but it has been an excruciatingly painful experience for him. Billy Graham is a driven man, and even in the face of this tragically career-ending injury, he has pushed his therapy to limits
that an ordinary individual could never endure.
Okay, it must be fatiguing a little bit. Hold it on the way down. There you go. Good.
One more?
Good.
One more. Let's do one more. I want to do one more.
Okay. Good. Try not to hold your breath.
Of course, Billy Graham is no ordinary individual, nor is he even an ordinary athlete. He is one of a very rare breed in the most elite class of athletes, a former world heavyweight champion. That title, of course, only comes to those who are blessed by nature with uncanny strength and determination. However, his apparent abundance of determination has his physicians concerned because too much activity, quite frankly, could be very dangerous. And they say a return to the ring is impossible. But for an athlete like Billy Graham, who has been pushing his limits to achieve his goals all of his life, it's hard to bet against the guy, even though it may look like he's trying to beat a royal flush. But comeback or not, we all must applaud his purpose, his struggle, and perseverance to get back to the squared circle. And yes, superstar Billy Graham insists that he will be back.
Give credit where it's due. Certainly, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat stated when he won the title, he was going to be a fighting champion, and he has done just that. He has taken on all comers. Over the top rope. No, look at this maneuver. Oh, look at that. Into the ring. Out comes the Honky Tonk Man, and the Dragon is breathing fire.
The Dragon's hot, but the match is far from over. Far from over. Beautiful back suplex.
The Dragon firing off the bullet shot. Honky Tonk Man may be sorry he signed on for the title match. Yes, indeed, the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat, really taking care of business this week.
You know, I think Honky deserves the shot over his big win over Jake the Snake in WrestleMania. I think that's what got it for him.
Big win, you call it, huh?
What did you call it? He won. And it certainly was big.
Maybe not on the record, but chopped to the pectoral area. Chop again. Honky Tonk Man reversing things on the Dragon off the rope. Honky Tonk missing the right outside. Behind him now. The Dragon's on the Honky Tonk debacle.
Maneuver
on the part of the Honky Tonk Man. Down the momentum, shifting back in the favor of the Honky Tonk Man. Dragon with a throat snapped off the top rope.
And look at Honky, went to school on him. He knows the Dragon has that injured larynx, and he's going after it.
Thanks to Savage, yes. Honky Tonk moving in now on the Dragon, and the Dragon fighting right back. Another chop by the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat. Honky Tonk Man hanging right in there, however. You can hear, of course, Jimmy Hart with that megaphone in the background.
That's got to be a lot of help to a wrestler in there, you know, knowing that Jimmy's behind him.
He missed it! And now, once again, the tide is turned. Steamer, ooh, what a kick that was to the ribs. Another one to the chest. Ricky Steamboat hammering away, chopping away on a Honky Tonk Man. Gets him out, snaps him over now. The Dragon measuring the Honky Tonk Man, maybe even at this moment sensing victory.
Oh, he's close. I'm not going to doubt it.
Honky Tonk Man off the rope.
Ooh. But as they say,
Right face lock. Honky Tonk Man moving it.
Whoa.
Nice maneuver by the Dragon.
That was a saving maneuver by the Dragon. He was ready to shake
Honky Tonk Man missed. Honky Tonk Man's coming like a head of steam. Ooh, now like a steamroller. But now it may be stopped. Downstairs goes the Dragon. Upstairs now. I don't think the Dragon has ever looked so good. Up to the apron.
He's going up.
The Dragon now. It was Jimmy Hart doing. Get him down from there. What a chop. Cover.
Hart's
turn around.
He's tied up.
Turn around. Turn around.
Whoa.
The following is a six-man attraction scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring at a total combined weight of 798 pounds, first from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, Iron Mike Sharp. From Kansas City, Ace Cowboy Bob Orton. And from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, the Magnificent Morocco.
For you to be more jealous now of the Colonel.
I'm not jealous of him. Will you quit saying that?
Six-man tag team action. The Magnificent One, Don Morocco, along with Ace, former henchman, Cowboy Bob Orton, and Iron Mike Sharp.
Now he's got two titles. That's fine.
I thought you said you weren't jealous.
I'm not jealous. I dropped that subject. I'm singing the praises off.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he's got the World Tag Team Champions and the Intercontinental Champion.
I know that.
Boy, what a claim to fame that is. Who you got? What, you got any titles? No, not a one.
You don't need me here. You ask the question and you answer it yourself.
Well, I want to get the right answer. Orton with a nice hip lock on Billy Jack. The powerhouse out of Portland, Oregon. Sitting there with a real ring technician and mechanic. Not too many guys can do what the Cowboy can do. Cat, got your tongue? Or should I say, has the mouth of the South got your tongue? Side headlock by Ace. He won't stay in this long. Got rid of him in a hurry. Nice shoulder block. Down in front quickly. Leapfrog of beauty. And a hip lock of his own. I tell you what, not only is Billy Jack a powerhouse, he's got speed as well. He's taking on the whole team.
Show off.
Guaranteed, he's still got a lot of scores to settle with one Hercules.
He better go back to Oregon and play in the trees.
That war is not over by a long shot, I don't think, Brent.
No, it's not.
Keep the mouth shut now of the Honky Tonk Man. Now that he's got the gold around his waist.
He earned it. I told you he was going to win it. I called it. I predicted it.
At least you're saying that. Not many believe in it.
I'll tell you, I even gave Jimmy a little insight. I helped him.
You helped him. You can't even help yourself. How are you going to help somebody else? SD in there along with Hillbilly. Calling in the third man as Iron Mike comes in. He got trapped in the corner. Oh, it's a big chain hookup now.
The ring's moving.
Whole ring shifted about 4 or 5 inches. And Morocco was at the bottom of all that.
The referee has lost control here.
Rams him into the head of Special Delivery Jones. And SD. The southpaw out of Antigua going to work.
Smallest guy in there, 250 pounds.
Big headbutt by SD. Look out. Oh, scoop slam. Morocco looking for his corner. A little bit dazed there. Makes the tag to Iron Mike. Nobody home as he telegraphed that one.
Wait a minute. Orton and Morocco are arguing.
Sometimes they have a difference of opinion. Oh, look at that. Morocco nailed his own man. And SD gets the cover. And look at Orton get on Morocco.
surprise here in a World Wrestling Federation. Jimmy Hart, you've got to be the luckiest and the happiest guy I've seen at a World Wrestling Federation. All of a sudden, the Honky Tonk Man is the brand new Intercontinental Champion of the world.
You know, this is the greatest day of my life. The Hart Foundation's of the world champions. And like you said, Daddy, the Intercontinental Champion is who? That's right, the Honky Tonk Man.
Please,
that's right.
Please.
And you're jealous. You're jealous of the Harts and you're jealous of the Honky Tonk Man. We're sitting on top of the world. You know, it's a lot of great teams out, like the Killer Bees, the Islanders, you know, Morocco. Hey, bring them all on, right, Daddy?
What about the Rajos? What about the new Greek team? What is it,
it's a big day for the foundation. A big day. Next thing you know, Danny Davis will be beating Hulk Hogan, and we'll have all the belts.
Well,
you can't underestimate the Hart Foundation.
The foundation
not
has
at this
all the
point.
Cookies.
One at a time, gentlemen. Yes, you were
not
saying.
At this point. Don't underestimate the Hart Foundation. Now let's talk about the teams. Let's talk about the Rougeaus.
Yes, and the British
big
Bulldogs.
Deal. The Bulldogs. They were a good team. Okay, we'll give them that much credit. They were a good team.
Wait a minute.
The Killer Bees. You know what the Killer Bees are?
They're red hot right
They're
now.
They're nothing more than two ruthless cheaters. That's and I don't know how they sleep at
Absolutely.
Night.
Absolutely.
How can you say that, Jim, the Anvil Neidhart?
Well, number one, everyone knows that when a bee stings someone, and the stinger comes out and that person, that bee stings that one, a bee dies after it stings one time. Everyone knows that fact, right?
That's right. And we've been stung once, and that's enough.
Never gonna happen again. Never
yeah,
say never. Never
issue,
say never.
Yeah, never say never. But they bring the masks out. Look at, you know, Jimmy, what do we have to do to beat the Killer Bees? Do we have to put masks on too? No, we don't. We don't have to hide our pretty faces.
Let's talk about other teams. What other teams do you want
what
to talk about?
What else do you want to talk about?
You want to talk about the Can-Ams?
Oh, you're throwing,
what do you want to talk about?
You want to talk about the Can-Ams?
You can talk about them. You threw me for a loop with the pretty faces, but go ahead.
You want to talk about the Can-Ams? I don't want to talk about the Can-Ams.
What about Demolition? Hey, I like them.
Well, what about the Demolition?
I think they're... I like them. They're a little off the wall. They're a little like you guys.
You know, you're jealous. You know, there's favoritism right there.
Yeah.
You know, something
oh,
else you
yeah.
brought up, too. You know, you knocked Danny Davis, a referee, right? What happened when we got swerved by the dead gum Killer Bees? Why didn't the referee put his hands and check these
yeah.
guys out? How
what about the dog? What about Danny? The dog?
Yeah.
Daddy.
What about the dog?
Matilda?
Yeah.
Look at just a little dog. You can't. The dog is not going to do you any harm.
Let me tell you something. There's a lot of people out there that better get used to the fact that the Hart Foundation will be the world champions for a long, long time.
All right, I thank you, Bret Hart, Jim Neidhart, Jimmy Hart. They are, indeed, the Hart Foundation.
Well, we're going to take a look at some special footage of the Honky Tonk Man right after he took the title away from the Dragon. What a celebration in the dressing room. Look at the entourage here of guys.
I'd say...
Oh, you did it, man! You beat him!
He did it, baby!
Congratulations!
You did it! You're the
man. Randy Savage was the first guy to congratulate him.
The first one right there on the scene.
Can't believe it. We're going to see you next week right here on Wrestling Challenge. In fact, newly crowned Intercontinental Champion, the Honky Tonk Man in singles competition. And we're also going to take at this guy, former Olympian. Take a look at him.
Shouldn't say Ken Patera.
Kenny Patera.
Should have numbers.
Please, give me a break.
And my men, my newest acquisition, the Islanders, Haku and Toma.
Coco, beware, and you can bet that Frankie won't be far behind, as we'll also take a look at this awesome tag team combination, the Demolition, also under the tutelage of Mr. Fuji. All that and a whole lot more right here next week on Wrestling Challenge. Until then, Gorilla for the Brain, saying so long.
I can say goodbye.
Goodbye.